Algonquin Young Readers and Workman Audio present Egg Marks the Spot, A Skunk and Badger Story by Amy Timberlake, performed by Michael Boatman. Chapter 1. Rap, rap. Rap, rap, rap. The knocking sounded on the attic door, the door of Badger's new rock room. It was his roommate, Skunk. Badger would ignore it. He will go away, he thought. Important rock work. Focus, focus, focus. Badger gritted his teeth and leaned forward on his rock stool. He adjusted his special work light and lifted the unidentified object on his rock table. He glanced at the list in his important rock work notebook. Igneous, granular groundmass, greenish, red phenocrysts, very sparkly. He looked at the object. He read the list again. He ran his paw over one of the object's phenocrysts and thought, it is time. Yes, it was time for the first question, rock or mineral? Mineral or rock? Minerals were made of one basic material, one element or an elemental compound, as the rock scientists said. There tended to be a sameness about a mineral. A rock, though, was a combination of minerals, or a combination of rocks and minerals. Two minerals stuck together, rock. Five minerals scrambled up with a rock chucked in, also a rock. The question, rock or mineral, was best asked loudly. It was followed by tossing the object into the air. When Badger caught the object, he would yell out the answer in a thunderous voice. Badger's ears twisted in the door's direction. No sounds. So Badger opened his mouth, inhaled, and rap, rap, rap. The rapping was insistent. Always, it insisted. Badger exhaled and waited for what he knew would come next. It came. Badger! Rap, rap, rap. Badger set his head upon the rock table. He had thought that moving his rock room from the living room to an out-of-the-way place like the attic would help. Strategic! He had thought at the time. Back then, a tug on the chain of the attic's one bare bulb revealed a jumble of cardboard boxes, broken luggage, an assortment of odd furniture, an aquarium, a stack of oil paintings, and a claw-footed bathtub filled with hats. Badger rotated his head to one side and spied the bathtub. The bathtub had refused to budge. So Badger had left the bathtub's third of the attic full of jumble and declared it useful storage with the added benefit of buffering the sound of his rock tumbler. Then he cleared out the remaining two-thirds for his rock room. Out of the jumble had come a chair and a reading lamp. The pool table worked wonderfully well for rolling out geological survey maps and the umbrella stand for storing them. Badger had utilized the attic cabinetry, lining drawers with soft velvet for hand lenses and magnifying glasses, his pocket utility knife, his scrapers and bradawls, his fine dust puffer. He'd hung hooks for hammers and chisels. Only when all this had been accomplished had Badger lugged his boxes of rocks and minerals, his table, his stool, and his work light up the two flights of stairs to the attic. Weeks of work, Badger groaned. Rap, rap, rap. Rap. Badger, are you in there? Badger. Badger ignored this and let his eyes take in what had once been a long, windowless wall. Badger had lined that wall with shelves. He'd installed light after tiny light. He'd written out name cards and found suitable stands, one for each specimen. Badger lifted his head. He pushed back from the rock table. The wheels of his stool clattered over the uneven floorboards. "Badger, is that you?" Badger stood. The stool jostled.
"Rap, rap."
Badger walked to the wall and flipped the light switch. Behold, Badger's wall of rocks! Under each light, a specimen shone, the exceptional, the one-of-a-kind, the rare and unrivaled. The copper shimmered. The mica sparked. The labradorite pulsed with color like some translucent deep-sea fish. "Yes," Badger whispered. Then his eyes alighted upon the empty stand at the beginning of his wall of rocks, and he felt a searing pain. He quickly looked away. A muttering from the other side of the door. "It sounds like he is in there. He is not in his room. He is not downstairs. He is definitely not in the kitchen, where he always is." Badger frowned. "I am not always in the kitchen." He put a paw on the doorknob and threw open the door. "Yes." Skunk, his paw on the door's opposing knob, flew into the room, along with a spatula that flipped free and a whisk that whistled by Badger's ear. Skunk caught himself with a grin. "You are here! I knew it! Funny how I flew!" Badger observed the smudged and spattered kitchen apron and the wild zag in Skunk's stripe. He spoke with emphasis. "The door was shut." Badger swept a paw in the direction of his rock table. Tools out, notebook shoved to one side, an unidentified object bathed in a pool of light. "Important rock work?" Skunk groaned. "This again? You think a closed door is so simple to understand, but as I have explained before, a closed rock room door means more than one possible scenario. Scenario one, you are working on important rock work. In scenario one, doors must not be knocked upon or opened unexpectedly, not even when lunch is on plates and cooling rapidly. Then there is scenario two. You go out for a paw pie at the Vegan Egger. You are not here, but your rock room door is shut." Skunk crossed his arms. "Badger, it is not easy to tell the difference between scenario one and scenario two. If you do not like knocking, you should clarify this situation." Badger shifted. "Lunch? Left out? To grow cold?" But Skunk's attention had been captured elsewhere. "Look at those rocks!" Skunk bounded to the windowless wall. He stuck his head near a shelf and squinted up. "One light, one rock. One light, one rock. One light, one rock." He nodded back at Badger. "Clever. That is why the rocks glow." Badger himself glowed. Skunk read the name cards. "Neptunite. Obsidian. Pyrite." Then Skunk stepped back and tapped his chin. "Alphabetical! You have arranged the rocks in alphabetical order." Badger nodded happily. "Rocks displayed alphabetically are so satisfactory. I call it," Badger paused for effect, "my wall of rocks." "Wall of rocks? Nice. The chickens will like your wall of rocks," said Skunk. Badger blinked. "Chickens in my rock room? Again? Badger remembered, with horror, the last time chickens had been in his rock room. Chicken coop d'etat! But then he thought of the tiny orange hen, no bigger than a pencil.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.